The funnel chart is a visualization extension that lets you add a sequential chart showing the connected stages of a process. Each stage decreases and contains a subset of the previous stage. Funnel charts show values across stages in a process. They can represent anything that decreases in size. Funnel charts show a process that starts at 100% and ends at a lower percentage. The chart shows the decrease at each stage and its rate. Each segment represents the value of a specific item. Segments can influence the size of other segments. The funnel chart is often used to represent stages in a sales process, showing the potential revenue for each stage. Funnel charts can also be used to illustrate website visitor trends, such as visitor homepage hits or downloads, and to show order fulfillment with initiated orders at the top, followed by orders in delivery, delivered orders, canceled orders, and returned orders. To create a funnel chart, drag and drop a funnel chart onto the sheet. Add a dimension to your chart. In this case, we add the lead status. Then add a measure. In this example, we'll use the number of leads. In appearance, you can customize the way the chart will be displayed. In this case, the funnel is displayed in width mode. The width of the upper edge is proportionate to the maximum value of the measure. The top segment is always 100%, and the following segments are relative in size to the first. The lowest segment is rectangular. This affects the shape of the funnel, and each segment has its individual slope. You have different options to present your data in a funnel chart. In this example, we'll choose height from the funnel mode drop-down list. You can color the chart by choosing from the different color options. In this case, we'll color the visualization by measure. With height mode, the height of each item is proportionate to the measure. Only the height of each segment is affected, not the overall chart or contents. The area mode is another option for presenting your data. In this mode, the area of each item is proportionate to the measure. Only the area of each segment is affected, not the overall chart or contents. In this case, we are going to color by measure, select the diverging classes option, and then click the reverse color checkbox. The last option that you have is the ordering mode. This mode orders the segments by value, but does not change the shape of the funnel. We are going to color the funnel using the diverging gradient option and clear the reverse color checkbox. As you can see, the funnel segments are ordered by value and the shape of the funnel is not affected. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.